this got me into all sorts of trouble, because people at the time didn't want to think that there could be any genetic influences on behaviour at all. And as a zoologist, this seemed so obvious to me. So that when I sat down to write The Naked Ape, and I only had 4 weeks in which to do it, I took a month's leave, and I had to write an 80,000 word book in 4 weeks, and that nearly finished me off. I thought that was day and night, non-stop. But I managed it, and I gave it, handed it over to my publisher. There wasn't even a carbon copy of it. It was just as it came off the typewriter, and I handed it to him, and he said, "Thank you very much," and he put it away. And then he read it over Christmas and got back to me very excited. He said, "I think this book's going to be really successful." And I said, "Well, who knows? I honestly didn't know what was happening. I thought I'd get into trouble for it, but I didn't expect it to do very much." And proof of that is that I just resigned from the Zoo to take up a new post as director of the Institute of Contemporary Arts. I had had 10 years at the Zoo, and I wanted to make a change, and I wanted to move back into my other great love, which was the world of art. And I got to know the people at the ICA, and I was lucky enough to get the appointment as director of that art institute. And I went there, and it was while I was there running the ICA that the book was going through the printers and getting ready for publication. And Tom Masher rang me up and said, "This book is going to be huge." And I said, "Oh, I'll believe it when I see it." I wouldn't have gone. People think, "Oh yes, I'm sure that's not true. I'm sure you thought it." But I said, "No, I wrote it from the heart. This is where I saw human beings. And I wanted to tell the story of what I thought human beings were all about. And if people read the book, that's fine, but I wasn't expecting very much." And then it took off. And it took off in a most extraordinary way. Today it is in the list of 100 bestsellers of all time. And I still find that hard to believe. It sold, I don't know, we're 12 million, we lost count. I don't know, it's probably more like 20 million by now, but we kept on counting the sales until it got to 12 million, and then we gave up. We just lost interest at that point. It was just a runaway bestseller, the sort of thing that you can't possibly predict. It went into about 30 or 40 languages. Or even went into things like Icelandic and Korean, and I mean every language in the world, and it became a runaway bestseller. And suddenly, for the first time in my life, because I'd never had any money, first time in my life I had some money. I couldn't believe it. And so Tom asked, "What are you going to do?" And I said, "I'm going to do a mini Gauguin. I'm going to go off to an island in the sun, and I'm going to paint." That's why I've been running an art institute. I've been a curator at a zoological society. I've been running research and doing all these things. It's time I took a break, and I'm going off, and I'm going to spend the money and have a time to myself. And so my wife and I went off to the island of Malta, bought a big house, and I set up a studio, and I started painting seriously.